Just having fun with the metronome here. I've spent thousands of hours with this little thing here, and maybe fun and metronome rarely belongs in the same sentence, but in this case it does, because we often practice. I used to practice, but I didn't really feel and sense and acknowledge the fact that I was making progress, because I wasn't measuring it. And once you start measuring it, you really will celebrate on a whole new level. And that's important, because that gives you motivation. So, and I see a lot of students actually leaving the guitar, being frustrated and giving up, although they experienced or could have experienced a ton of progress. So how do we do this? How do we get to that point where we're really, you know, celebrating our progress and feeling and sensing it? And it's measuring it. If you don't measure, you won't really see it. It's like, you know, if you know you have some kids in your family, other people's kids, and you don't see them every day. And maybe it's 3 months ago, you saw the kids the last time and you go, whoa, you've grown so much, right? And the parents don't see that because they're with them every day. And the same thing happens when you practice. You do improve, but the improvements are incremental. So you get used to your new skill level every single day without really noticing it. And so a month goes by and you might have improved 10, 15, 20, 25% on whatever, let's say it's alternate picking skills, but you don't have any experience of it because it's so slow, the incremental improvements. But when you use a metronome, what I discovered was I used to write down just practically, I used to write down, you know, how fast I was. So I was practicing any sequence. A really good method is I was practicing any sequence, right? And then I was just, you know, I decided to play it like 100 times, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I was just sit there counting, right? And then I did 100 of that, and I brought it up one click, and I did 100 again. While staying in total control and not making a lot of mistakes. And then I was just going up, 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 and at some point I was losing control. It's like, I can't play it because I wasn't certain that the next note would come out right. And that was the point that you have to stop and go back and then try to see if you can push beyond that by, you know, going back 10 clicks and then trying to move down again. Practice some more, see if you can move beyond that. But then when my practice session ended, I would write down what tempo I was I got to, so I could start or know for the next day. And then gradually, as I, you know, wrote in my little journal, just a piece of paper just on the table where I was practicing, I could actually see my progress, and that was enormously motivating. Suddenly, I could see that week one, I was at this level, week two, on this level, and then I started writing down how much I was practicing and how many repetitions I was doing. So just for fun, right? So I counted it and I wrote a little line on the paper. Each time I did 100 and then 100, one more and one more line, and then over when you did 500, right? So I started measuring everything. And so I could see, I not only felt extremely motivated because I could see that I was progressing, I also could see what made that happen. So I had the cause and I saw the effect. I got motivated by the effect, and I could be intelligent about how much effort, how many repetitions, what do I need to do, for how many minutes do I need to practice in order to get X amount of improvement. And that was just like a scientist suddenly. I could see, okay, so I did this much, and I got this much. So if I doubled this, if I could put in some more hours, or I could just, you know, go further, just practice 8 weeks instead of 4, then I can have this. And suddenly a new level of certainty was in me. Instead of, you know, I'm just practicing and, you know, when you practice a lot, you get results. And, you know, most people just rely on that. Suddenly I was just like fired up because I knew I would get the results, right? Because I had that cause and effect relationship I was working on. And then I tried to improve the cause effect. I tried to be more efficient when I was practicing, right? See what I could else do to really improve the results I got. So it's a totally new world when you start using the metronome, start measuring your progress, start writing down how much time you spend, how many repetitions, you start counting them, because then you can really feel and see the improvements you make, and that makes you extremely motivated and passionate about it. And then you can be intelligent about what makes what happen and what you need to do to get the results you want. And then you can move on with certainty in your body of, I can really do this. This is so, you prove to yourself that you can do it. So that is, I really hope you'll take this into consideration and start using a metronome. If you don't want to use the metronome, at least record yourself. Whenever you start practicing a new thing, record yourself. Put up your iPhone, whatever, and then just do it. And then a week later, 2 weeks later, record yourself again. So you actually feel the progress. You feel and see and hear what goes on. And you see those kids grow. Instead of just, you know, not noticing it. But right now, go to my website and download my free course on alternate picking mastery. I used to hammer away at it. I used to spend several hours a day practicing alternate picking mastery, and I was getting nowhere until it dawned on me that I had to separate this master skill of alternate picking up into its sub-skills. Then I designed individual exercises that targeted each skill, and then I could collect these sub-skills and really master alternate picking on a whole new level. When I did that, I started making some serious progress. And if you use the skills, the insights we've been talking about today, you will feel that progress, and you will measure what it takes in order to get to it. So you'll build that certainty, and you'll use a bundle of exercises that actually gives you what you want. And I also included a little session where we talk about how to develop a practice plan in 2 minutes that will be the most effective way of practicing that you have ever tried in your life, if you haven't already done so or used this method. So please go download it right now. It should really have a price tag on it, but it hasn't. So please, please go download it before I change my mind. I'll see you in another free video.